might be at home, I might be in the garden, there may be small people running around or animals, so I apologise in advance for the chaos, but let's just enjoy the tranquility of being here today. So we're going to start by setting our posture and then warm up from there. So let's just open your feet out to hip width apart and parallel, spread your toes out wide and just gently rock your way forward onto the balls of your feet and back onto your heels, forwards and back. Just feeling your core kick in there as you transfer your weight forward and back. Lovely, and then soften your feet down so your weight's even from the front to the back of each foot. And then just rocking over onto one side and the other. That's it. And again, bring your weight into the centre so your weight is even from the right foot to the left foot as well as front to the back of the foot. And then moving up, just make sure your knees are soft and not knocked back. And then coming up to your pelvis, tuck your tailbone under and release back. So imagine your pelvis is like a big bony bowl full of water and you're going to tilt a little bit of water out the back of the bowl and the front of the bowl. So it's back and forward one more time. Back and forward. And if I come to a stop halfway between those two end positions where your pelvis is upright, and just think about lifting your rib cage up and out of your pelvis, picture a helium balloon attached to the crown of your head that's drawing you upwards, and relax your shoulders away from your ears. Lovely. Let's take a deep, wide breath in here, and relax completely to exhale. And again, deep, wide breath in, and relaxing to exhale. On the next exhale, I'd like you to set your centre. So imagine you're wearing a low, snug belt that's got about 10 notches, and you're going to draw that belt in just about 3 notches, and keep breathing through that contraction as you start to engage those deep abdominal muscles that help to support your pelvis and your lower back. Great, let's start warming up from here. So bring your right ear to your right shoulder, take a deep breath in, and exhale, tuck your chin in, and roll over to the other side. Hold there to inhale, and exhale, roll. And again, hold to inhale, and exhale, roll. And one more time, holding to inhale, and exhaling to roll. Good, hold right into the right shoulder, just soften your shoulders away from your ears, reach down through that right hand, and circle out the left shoulder. Good, keep your centre set, keep going with those deep, wide breaths, so utilising your lung capacity. Good, two more circles here, and last one, soften that shoulder down, take a deep breath in, and exhale, tuck your chin in, roll to the other side. And hold there, soften your shoulders away from your ears. And circle out your right shoulder. Good, I think we could all do with a little bit of this. Keep cycling out, two more circles. And last one. Now you bring your head back into the centre circle, both shoulders out here. And let's bring this into an upper back stretch. So you're going to circle up, as you circle down, interlock your fingers, tuck your chin onto your chest, reach up to shoulder height, hold there to breathe in, breathe out, lift up, turn to move your hands, hold there to breathe in, and out to open. Let's do that again, circling up to breathe in, and breathing out to reach up to shoulder height, hold there to breathe in, breathe out, lift up, keep that tailbone slightly tucked, centre set, hold to breathe in, and out to okay, from here, let's take the feet open a little bit wider, turn your feet slightly out and soften into your knees. I'd like to keep your centre set. We're going to reach up and do some upper body reaches. So shift your ribcage to one side and lift up, and then switch to the other side and lift. Pelvis stays in the centre, legs stay still. It's just your ribcage that's shifting from side to side. And just be aware if it feels a little bit easier towards one side than the other. It's a little bit stiffer or tighter on one side. Good, two more to each side. And one more to each side. Good. And back to the centre. Reach your arms forward. Let's work into rotation. So breathing out, open, out. Breathing in, back to the centre. Exhale, open. Inhale, centre. Good. Keep your pelvis facing forward. Keep your legs still. And centre. Okay. Let's just add in a bit of a softening into the knees. So exhaling to lower down. Inhaling to the centre. Inhale, centre. Just getting those legs working a little bit. Keep squeezing your hands for each up and over. Good. Into the centre. And out to reach. Into the centre. And out to reach. Again, keep your legs still. Keep anchoring down through your feet. Keep squeezing to your buttocks to keep your hips open wide. Great work, guys. Two more to each side. Stay nice and low. I know the legs are starting to warm up a little bit. Stay down there. Reach. And centre. Last one to each side. Exhale, reach. Inhale, centre. And one more. And centre. Great work. Come back up again. Just relax your shoulders off for a moment. And then we're going to keep the feet open wide for some squats. So let's lower and lift here. As you do this, just make sure your collarbones are staying open. You're not collapsing down through your shoulders. Good. Down and up. Good. Four more. Down and up. Three more. Lovely. Two more. And last one. I'd like you to come down and hold. Good. Just think about each foot having three corners. So you've got your peel, your pad below your big toe, and your pad below your little toe. So picture those three corners on your right foot and your left foot. Make sure your weight is even over those three corners. Don't come up yet, stay low. Good. Knees should be pointing over your second and third toe. Pelvis is upright, centre is set. Everyone happy? Good. Then come a little bit lower. Tuck your elbows in. Let's open out into a dumb waiter and fold back in. Go on, a little bit longer. Seven. And in. Good. Keep going. Six. And in. And five. And in. Keep it nice and slow. I know you're really enjoying this one. Four more. And fold in. Three more. And in. Well done. Two more. Exhaling out. Inhaling in. How are those legs? Whew. Well done. And come up. Give your legs a shake out. Great work. Well done. Okay. I hope you're all feeling a little bit warmer. We're just going to do a little bit of work for the feet and the ankles. So bring your feet directly under your hips. Set your centre. And let's lift and lower. Up into some heel raises here. Lift and lower. And lift and lower. Okay. We're going to come back to those dumbwaiter arms. So I'd like to tuck your elbows in at your waist, and as you lift, you're going to open out and fold back in again. Exhale out, inhale in, good. Exhale, inhale, good. Out and in, good. Four more like that. And in, three more. And in, two more. Excellent, great work, guys. Come up and hold. Keep those heels lifted. Let's just do one arm at a time, folding in. And out, that's it. Keep those heels up. Keep your feet as still as you can. Not an easy one. Go on, keep going. Four more here. Keep those heels lifted. Well done. Three more. In and out. Two more. Oh, I've lost it. And last one. Anyone who's used to coming to my classes knows that that's very normal for me. Relax your shoulders out. I'm sure you all did a lot better at home than I did. So, a little bit more balance work. I'd like to stand on one foot and just pick one foot up behind you. Bring your knees together. Stand up a little bit taller. Tuck your tailbone under. Squeeze your glutes. So you get that nice opening into the front of the thigh. That's it. Keep that tailbone tucked. Make sure you don't overarch with this one. A lot of people end up arching through here. You want to stay tucked. And switch sides. Right, so we're going to come down onto the mat into kneeling on hands and knees. If your knees are a little bit sore, please feel free to grab an extra mat or get some towels for padding under your knees, okay? So we'll take the hands under the shoulders. If you don't like being on your wrists, then you can go on your elbows for these ones. So hands or elbows under shoulders, knees under hips. I'd like to lift your chest away from the mat, slide your shoulder blades back, and draw in through your abdominals. Let's do some reaches. So as you exhale, you're going to reach away one arm on the opposite leg. And inhale back to the centre. Exhale to reach. Inhale to the centre. Good. each way, one arm and the opposite leg, and then draw circles from the shoulder, keeping everything else totally still. If you'd like to make it a little bit more challenging, you could lift up the foot that is resting on the mat and reverse the circles. Hopefully you can't see all the shaking that's going on in my arm right now. Two more circles. And last one, lovely, stop there, lower the hands and knee down, and arch your back up. And release down, let's try that on the other side, shall we? So engage your abdominals, reaching away, and circling out the shoulder. Again, to make it harder, you float up the foot that is resting on the mat. A bit like a seesaw here. Keep circling out, reverse those circles. Well done, guys. Really good work. Two more circles. And last one. Excellent. Lower your hand and your knee down. Sit your hips back behind you. Have a stretch. And then come back into kneeling on hands and knees. Okay, we've got one more set of circles here. So lift your chest away from the mat. Slide your shoulder blades back. Engage your abdominals. I'd like to reach away one arm on the opposite leg. And this time you're going to circle from the hip, keeping everything else totally still. Keep drawing in through the abdominals. If you'd like to make it harder, make your circles a bit bigger and faster. Two more in this direction. Good, and reverse those circles. Big circles there, keeping that distance from fingertips to toes. Keep breathing, two more. And last one, excellent. Stop there, lower the hands and knee down. Have a stretch into whichever direction you would like to. Okay, then let's finish off on the other side. So lift your chest away from the mat, slide your shoulder blades back, and reach away. Let's circle out from the hip. Everything else stays totally still. Keep reaching through those fingertips. Keep your center set. Good, it's a nice one for working the back as well as your glutes, so your buttock muscles and the back of the shoulders too. Reverse those circles. Abdominals are working too, so it's a nice all rounder. Excellent, keep circling. Three more. And two. And last one. And stop there. Very nice work. Again, have a stretch into whichever direction your body would like to. Okay. And then push forward onto your elbows. Right, so we're going to do a little bit of abdominal work here. So I'd like to keep your elbows under your shoulders and lift your chest away from the mat and slide your shoulder blades back. So from here, you're going to draw in through the abdominals and you're going to lift your hips up off the mat and tuck your tailbone under, really pulling in through the abdominals. And then you're going to inhale and lower back down again. So exhale, pull in through the abdominals, round through your lower back, tuck your tailbone under, and inhale, and lower back down again. So often when we're taught to plank, we plank in a really straight line. There's nothing wrong with that at all. It's a good thing. But here we're rounding through the lower back to really isolate the abdominal muscles. So the more you can tuck under through your tailbone, the more you're going to engage your oblique abdominal muscles. Good, keep going. Two more. Exhaling up, pulling through those abdominals, tuck your tailbone under. Inhale, lower down. Good, last one. And lower down. Anyone else's shoulders hurting? Mine are really sore. Right. It's probably because this is about the 16th take of this. Just kidding, not really. We might have done a couple. Right, okay, let's keep going. If that was quite challenging for you, I'd like you to stick at that level. If you would like to make it a little bit harder, then follow me. So elbows under shoulders, lift through your ribcage, slide your shoulder blades back, draw in through the abdominals, and come up into your lifted position. If you'd like to make it harder, you're going to tuck your toes under, and then you're going to lift and lower one knee at a time. Core stays totally still. It's just your legs that are moving. Back stays still. Keep pulling in through those abdominals, keep breathing through it. You've got four more, three more, last two, and last one. Well done, really nice work. And rest back down again. Good. really great ones for postural stability. So keep breathing, happy thoughts here. Let's go. 10 more, switch. 9 and switch, keep going. 8 and 7, keep breathing. 6 more and 5. No matter how hard you're finding this, imagine how hard it is to do it whilst talking at the same time. Now, where was I? 8 more? No, not quite. Right, let's get 4 more and switch. 3 and switch. Last 2. Woo! And last 1. Very nice work. That was hard. Let's relax the shoulders off. So bring your arms alongside your body, tuck your chin in, forehead down, and just circling the shoulders up to your ears. Squeeze in, reach away. And relax down and again. Up, in, away, and down. Keep circling out. Okay, we're going to keep going with those shoulder circles, but we're going to start to bring in a little bit of work for the lower back as well. So as you circle in and away, you're going to float your chest and forehead up off the mat, and inhale to lower down. Up, squeezing in, reach away, and lower down. Keep looking down at the mat to keep that length into the back of the neck. Okay. We're going to build into this, so I'd like to start bringing your lower body too. As you float up through your chest and forehead, squeezing into your glutes, and lower down. Exhaling up. Inhale down. Good. Keep going. 4 more. 3 more. Great work, guys. 2 more. Keep looking straight down. Exhaling up. Inhaling down, and last one. And lower down. Just relax off into a comfortable position. Great. Okay. We're going to continue to work a little bit for the lower back because we've done a lot of work for the abdominals. So this time, I would like you to bring one hand on top of the other and rest your forehead onto the back of your hands. We're going to do some breaststroke prep and then a bit of full breaststroke. So from here, I'd like to just tuck your tailbone under a little bit and you just allow your hip bones to lift a fraction from the mat, and we're going to keep that lightness between the hip bones and the mat. So from here, as you exhale, you're going to float the back of your head up towards your ceiling and then inhale to lower down. So tuck your tailbone under again, pulling through the abdominals, exhale up, inhale. Remember, this one's quite a small movement because you're keeping your tailbone tucked and it's mainly coming from the middle bit of your back, not your lower back. Great, keep going, 4 more like that, exhaling up, inhaling down. Two more. Excellent, and last one. Exhale up and inhale down. Again, rest off into a comfortable position. Let's do a set of full breaststrokes. So nice one for opening out through the front of the shoulders and the chest and working the whole of your back. So for this one, you're going to tuck your tailbone under slightly, engage your abdominals. You're going to exhale to float up, inhale, reach forward, exhale, open out and around. And again, inhale, reach, exhale, open out. Keep going, inhale, reach, exhale, open out. Keep going, guys, 6 more here. If you'd like to make it a little bit harder, you can lift your legs up off the mat, keep those legs lifted, inhale, reach, exhale, open, inhale, reach, exhale, open. Go on, guys, keep going, 4 more, inhale, reach, exhale, open, 3 more, inhale, exhale, 2 more, excellent, and last one, inhaling to reach, exhaling to open, and rest down there, very good work, have a little relax off. We're going to stay in this position to do a set of cobras, which is a really nice mobility exercise, and then we're going to change into lying on our back to finish off with. So for your cobra, I'd like to take your arms out to the side. If your back's quite flexible, slide your elbows in a little bit at your waist. intention is at the top to pop your elbows out and let your shoulders shrug up towards your ears. So keep those elbows soft, shoulders relaxed. Good, and last one coming down. Bring your hands under your shoulders, draw in through your abs. Have a little stretch here. One more deep breath in here, and exhale to bring your knees back into the centre. Lovely, let's have a stretch here. Lift one leg up towards the ceiling, hold on behind the knee, circle out the ankle. Keep straightening out that knee as much as you can, get that nice stretch into the back of the leg, and reverse in circles. Into your face.